In this video, I'm going to show you guys how to use all the features in the SlideShow tab in PowerPoint. So without further ado, let's get started. All right, so this is how you can find the SlideShow tab in PowerPoint. If you're on the Home tab right now, just go all the way over here to the right and click on SlideShow. Once you have that selected, you're then going to see all the different features right here available to you in the SlideShow tab. So let's start from the beginning, and literally the first feature is from the beginning. So let's click on from the beginning. And what this is basically going to do is start your presentation from the beginning as if you're going to present it to whoever it may be or even yourself. All right, so then if you want to say from current slide, if you have slide 6 selected and you hit from current slide, it's then going to pull up your presentation in presentation mode and it's going to start on that slide that you have selected. All right, then you can hit escape to go back. Now let's say you want to present online. I personally have never used this feature ever in my entire life, but it looks like you can present online for Skype for Business or even Office Presentation Service. Now, feel free to explore these two features, but in this tutorial, I'm not gonna go too far in depth with how to present online, just because I personally have never felt the need to use either of these two features. Next, we have a custom slideshow. So let's say you want to only show certain slides. If you click on this drop-down menu and then you hit custom shows, you then can hit new and allow you to select what slides you specifically want to only show in your PowerPoint presentation. So let's say I want to show slide 1, slide 3, and slide 5. Then we can say add. And now we're going to have these three slides in our slideshow presentation. We can either move this up if we want slide 5 to show first, and then maybe slide 1 shows second. We can also remove them if we want. And then if we ever want to add more, we can always click here and then hit the add button to add more. So once we hit OK, we then can do show right here. And now what this is going to do, it's going to show those slides in that specific order. So my first slide is going to be slide 5, then we have slide 1, and then I believe this was slide 3. And then if we hit the right arrow one more time or even just click, it's going to end that presentation. So why you'd want to use custom slideshow? Well, maybe you're trying to present only very specific slides in a giant master deck that you have and you want a very specific order, but you don't want to mess around the ordering of how your slides are laid out right here. This is a great way to do it. And now you'll see that this custom show 1 is showing right here. So if you go back to custom shows, you can easily delete this one if you want to remove it, or you can create new ones. You can edit it. You can change the names right here if you want to edit the name, or you can even add more slides or remove them, whatever you want. You can customize right here and then hit OK, and then it'll update right there. So this is just a really cool way on how to have a very customized presentation. Next, we have a setup slideshow. So if you click on this, it's then going to allow you to pick a bunch of different settings on how you actually want to set up your slideshow. So let's say you want to do presented by speaker full screen, or browse by individual window, or browse at kiosk full screen. These settings might be a very particular use case, so don't feel too overwhelmed if you don't know what all these really mean. I personally have never really used this feature myself, so I'm also learning as well about what these different features exactly mean, but just know these features are available to you to really customize if you're trying to have maybe like a pen color or if you have a laser pointer for your PowerPoint presentation. These are all great features to manipulate here. All right, so I'm just gonna cancel all that. Now, the next one we have is hide slide. So if you want to hide a slide, you can easily right click on it and then say hide slide, or you can click right here and this will also do the same thing of hiding that slide. Now, what do hide slides do? Well, if you hide a slide, it's still going to show right here, but if you're in your presentation mode, it's not going to show any of the slides that are hidden in your presentation. We'll actually skip over that slide and go to the next one without the audience even knowing that that slide exists. All right, the next is rehearse timing. So let's say you have a speech that you want to give for your PowerPoint presentation. You don't have like a clicker or anything or a mouse and you're not close to a computer and you just want to time out your entire presentation so that each slide advances with exact timing of how you're going to talk about your presentation. Rehearse timings is a great way to solve that problem. Basically, if you click on this, what's then going to do is you're going to see this timer up here, and it's going to start counting the time as to how long it takes for you to talk on each slide. Once you're ready to go to the next slide, you can hit this right arrow, and then you can talk for however long you want on that slide, and it's going to count up the time for how long it takes for you to talk on this slide. Once you're done with timing out your slides for, let's say you have a very rehearsed schedule on how long each slide needs to be and how long you're going to talk on each one without having to click manually. Another thing is, if let's say you need to pause it, you just need some time to think about what you're going to say on that slide, you can hit pause and they'll say recording has paused, and then you can always resume recording to get back into the timing of this slide. So that's a really great way. And then let's say you are done with rehearsing the timing for those slides, you can hit the escape key. And then right here, this window is going to pop up saying the total time for your slideshow was 20 seconds. Do you want to save the new slide timings? You could say yes. And now if we go here and click on this slide right here, and then we go to transitions, you're going to see how long these timings are for each one of these slides. And these are all custom based on how long we were talking for each slide. So in order to see that, you do have to go to transitions. And then you can go back to slideshow and continue doing rehearsed timings. Now, these will only transition automatically if you do have this check marked where after a certain amount of time, let's have this slide proceed to the next slide. If you don't want to do that and you want to do it on mouse click, just uncheck mark that, and then it'll only proceed to the next slide on a mouse click. Now, I would probably suggest just having a clicker or use a mouse to click through each slide, but this is a great way if you don't have either of those options and you're just wanting to have a very well timed out presentation. The next feature we have is record slideshow. So if I click right here, it's then going to open up my first slide or whatever slide I had selected. And then it's also going to actually pop open this window right here. If you have a second monitor, it's going to pop up right there. I don't know what it usually looks like if you only have one. Usually it just shows your presentation right here and then this in the second window. And then what it's going to do is allow you to record this actual slide. And then down here, you'll see the options to actually include audio and video. So if I turn on audio, it then will allow me to select the option to do video. So right now my laptop's actually closed completely, so it's not going to show my actual face. But if I were to click this, it's then going to pop open my webcam on my laptop. And right now it's just a black screen because my laptop is closed. But then I also have the option to hit this turn on camera preview, and either I can turn it on or off depending on what I want to show. All right. So then what you can do is once you're ready to record, you can hit record. It's going to count down for you. And then you can choose to just talk about how you want to talk about. Maybe you have some transitions, keep going through it. Maybe you want to draw on this slide. You can use this pen tool and just draw however you'd like. Maybe you want to pause just to collect your thoughts real quick about what you want to talk about next. And then you could hit record and that will resume the recording. And then if you're all done with the recording, you can always hit stop. And then what you can do is you can exit out of this. Let's say you mess this up, you could always clear it. So that will actually, if you hit this drop down menu, it will actually give you the option to clear recordings on current slide or on all slides. So let's say you messed up this one slide and you want to redo it. You can always hit clear recordings on current slide if you want to do that. Same with the settings for here. This allows you to choose what microphone you want to use and what webcam. So if you have an external webcam, it will probably also give you that option. So once you're done with that, you can exit out, and then you can exit out right here. And now whenever someone opens up this presentation, they're going to see this webcam right here. This normally would be a video of me talking through the webcam, but right now it's just a black screen because my laptop is closed. And if they went in presentation mode, not only would they start to hear audio, but they would also see my face right here. And then they would do the same thing right here. And let's say I was drawing on the screen like I did for this recording, they'll see it right there. So let's say, you know, maybe you're a teacher or whatever use case it may be, and you want to share a presentation with someone and walk through the presentation. This is a great way to share the story of this presentation with someone so that they can open it up themselves, click through each slide and hear what you have to say about the information on each slide. All right, so the next features you have for setup is play narrations, use timings, and show media controls. So this is just going to allow you to toggle on and off these features and whether or not you want to include them. Lastly, we have monitors. So a lot of times you'll notice when I go into presentation mode like this, it's going to present my presentation on this window right here. What you guys don't know though is that I have two other screens available to me. So if I want to include it on my laptop screen, I would pick this one. If I want on my primary monitor, I would then pick this one. And this will actually allow me to present it on a different window. So then it'll show me all my notes on this screen and then present on a different one. All right, so that is just a quick way on how to choose what monitor it's going to present on. Obviously, if you only have one monitor, it's going to automatically choose just that single screen. But if you are having issues with selecting which monitor it should present on, this is a quick way to manipulate that. And then you could also say use presenter view if you are wanting to see this feature, or you can uncheck mark it if you don't want to have that feature available to you. So that is everything within the slideshow tab in PowerPoint. If you did like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you could subscribe, I would greatly appreciate the support. Also, if you are interested in learning all things related to PowerPoint, I do have a course available on Udemy, so I'll have a link to that in the description below. But without further ado, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day, and I hope to see you guys in future videos. Thanks.